We want to write the exponential function f of t equals 100 times e raised to the power of 0.2t in the form g of t equals a times b raised to the power of t. In both exponential functions, a represents the initial value or initial amount. So if this is 100 here, a is 100 in this equation as well.
But for an exponential function with base e,
the coefficient of the exponent, or in this case 0.2, gives us the continuous exponential growth or decay rate. And because this is positive, we know this function models a 20% continuous growth rate. In g of t,
b minus 1
is going to give us the exponential growth or decay rate per unit of time. So if t is years, we can use b to find the exponential growth or decay rate per year. So this is a continuous growth rate, and b will help us find the growth rate per unit of time. To do this conversion, we'll use two function values or two points from f of t. We already know the initial value in both cases is equal to 100. To emphasize this, let's go ahead and use f of 0. Well, f of 0 is equal to 100 times e to the 0, which is 1. So this would be 100. If f of 0 equals 100, this would correspond to the point where the x-coordinate, or in this case the t-coordinate, is 0, and the y-coordinate is 100. Let's also use f of 1. So we would have 100 times e raised to the power of 0.2. We'll get our decimal approximation here. 100 times e raised to the power of 0.2. This will be approximately 122.1403. Which means this represents the point when the t-coordinate is 1 and the y-coordinate is 122.1403. Now we can find g of t. Again, we already know that a is going to equal 1. We should already recognize a is equal to 100. So we have g of t equals 100 times b raised to the power of t. So now we'll use the second function value, or second point, to determine our base b. G of 1 must also equal 122.1403. So we'll have g of 1 equals 100 times our unknown base raised to the power of t, which is 1, equals the function value 122.1403. Now, because this is rounded, we are going to have a slight margin of error, but we can see this will be 100b equals 122.1403, divide both sides by 100. We have b is equal to 1.2214, again, if we round to four decimal places. So that means g of t, the function we're trying to find, is equal to 100 times our base of 1.2214 raised to the power of t. So this function tells us that if we take the base and subtract 1, the growth rate would be approximately 22.14% per unit of time. So if t was in years, this would be a 22.14% growth rate per year, which is the same as a continuous growth rate of 20%. To verify that our work is correct, let's go ahead and compare the function values of f of t and g of t using the table of a graphing calculator. So I've already typed in the original function in y1. Of course, we have to use x instead of t. And I've typed in the function that we found in y2. And now we'll compare the function values using the table feature. So I'll press second graph. Now there might be a slight difference in y1 and y2 because we did have to round our base here. But if we scroll down, we can see that the values of y1 and y2 are equal to each other, though at some point there is going to be a slight margin of error. But this is more than enough information to verify that our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.